Oh, it's on, bitch.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. So it was maybe 2-3 weeks ago, Josh, you had done a story about PETA demanding that the animals in cages on boxes of animal crackers be set free to run wild in the cardboard jungle. And it was at that moment that if you went to their Facebook page and you saw that story and all that, and you read the comments, diehard supporters were like, y'all might have lost the plot a little bit here with me. Think we're going to give our money to the SPCA and Barks. And yes, it got eyes on them, but everyone was thinking, you've got a bit of a reputation for being crazy, and now you're kind of proving it to us. And then they just double down on the bananas less than a week later and try and take on an institution here in Baltimore. Jimmy's Famous Seafood. John Minadakis joins us. Good morning, sir.
Good morning, guys.
They put the billboard up saying, I'm not meat, I'm me. What the hell was it? It showed some crab tap dancing.
Yeah, I mean, just like you said, I feel like they were really feeling brave the week after they got the victory over Nabisco with the animal crackers. And they said, well, you know, where else can we get some over-the-top publicity and make people change their minds about something that they're steadfast in their ways? And they said, oh, look, you know, they eat crabs in Maryland. Let's go take down Maryland.
Flew a little close to the sun because little did they know that behind the scenes with social media and what have you, there's just like Wendy's level biting, roasting, cock lock and ready to rock to go back at them. And you go and put up your own billboard, just basically spitting it right back in your face. I hung out with you at the bar, not maybe a day or two before you put that billboard up. Give me some facts about what their billboard ended up doing for your business.
Oh, man. You know, first of all, I probably should thank PETA. Thank you, card, at the very least. Maybe some roses, too.
Yeah.
Crab cakes for sure. But, you know, I think the entire state of Maryland really rallied behind Jimmy's because, you know, we were the only ones that did fight back.
Yeah, they put up the billboard that said, I'm me, not meat. See the individual go vegan. And then you put up your own billboard that said, steamed crab with the me in steamed, capitalized. Steamed crabs here to stay, get famous. Jimmy's Famous Seafood with a picture of a steamed crab. So you fired shots right back.
Yeah, I mean, I felt attacked.
Yeah.
Our entire industry. I mean, I know crabbers in Chrisfield, crab pickers all up and down the Eastern Shore that depend on crab meat. It's not a joke to them.
You know,
people thought it was funny at first, but look, you know, if you're trying to put crabbers and the crab industry out, you know, there's going to be tens of thousands of Marylanders that can't provide for their families. So, of course, you know, we were going to fire back because nobody else did. So
a lot of times people do just sort of acquiesce very quickly, like, no, don't come here and splash blood on our fur coat. And they give in. I mean, Nabisco just pulled their pants down to their ankles immediately and gave in when people were. I don't think anybody would have been mad at Nabisco and animal cracker sales would have gone down. But it wasn't just the billboard you put up. It was the social media roast where
You went back and forth on Twitter, right, too?
Yeah, I mean, they just they didn't do their research because the funny thing is that everything that you're seeing on Twitter and social media these days, you guys know because you guys have seen Jimmy's grow up.
Yeah, yeah.
Is, well, that's our MO. You know, we punch back. We don't lay down for anybody. And, you know, we're not these, you know, corporate guys in suits. You know, we're Baltimore through and through. And if you're going to hit us, we're going to hit back.
And you said that you went from 15,000 followers, which is nothing to sneeze at. Then it goes to 40. Then it goes to 60. Then it jumps to 80. And then when I stop by your restaurant, you're like, we're getting orders from around the world, countries I've never even heard of. We're sending crab cakes to states that we've never shipped before, to where their campaign not only didn't work, it completely blew up in their face and businesses through the roof.
Justin, this past weekend, we had people coming in from Montana, Memphis, Hawaii, California, just because of all the publicity that we've been getting for punching back. And they said it was such a breath of fresh air to see, you know, a small business hit back at PETA. And they just wanted to come and show support. On the way here, we had people from Scotland tweeting at the restaurant saying, we're planning a trip from Scotland to come eat there.
Damn.
I think, you know, the culture is definitely changing. People are just really throwing the PC stuff out the window.
And you were on one of the cable news networks. What was that, Fox News?
Yeah, and, you know, I got a bone to pick with you guys. We were on Fox News, yeah. Travel Channel, yeah. ESPN, yeah. Barstool.
Yeah. Yeah.
But the only station I actually listened to, 98 Rock,
here now.
Took 2 weeks to invite me.
In Ravens, man. We were,
I had a bumper sticker on my Bronco for 5 years, and I can't get invited in the studio?
We're up to here with Ravens coverage, man. We're
scared
the
of PETA.
Yeah, we're terrified of them. I don't want to get blood.
Is any part of you scared? I mean, I don't know what you would be scared of, but throughout this whole process, before you put the billboard up, before all the Twitter wars, did you or maybe anybody in the Jimmy's Famous camp go, maybe we don't want to do this?
These guys are kind of known for some extreme
responses.
Or
was it always just, you know?
No, you know what's scary, man? Not being able to open your doors the next morning. So when somebody's coming after your livelihood.
Yeah, yeah.
That's the only thing that's scary. So, no, I wasn't scared one bit. We're still not scared.
Hell,
you know, Tony's not scared.
Yeah.
Kenny's not scared. Garrett's not scared. Now, None of us are scared.
We're talking to John Minadakis, Jimmy's Famous Seafood out there, Hollabird Avenue in Dundalk, taking on PETA, who's trying to put some billboards up around the city about steamed crabs. And then I think I saw something on social media where you said you went to the PETA headquarters in Baltimore or something, or the offices?
Norfolk.
Oh, it is Norfolk.
Yeah,
okay,
Norfolk.
That's what I was going to ask.
3 hour drive. So
the closest PETA office is in Norfolk.
Yeah, it's actually their only shelter in the entire country, believe it or
really?
Not. So, all you know, the millions of dollars they raise, they have one shelter. And that one shelter, by the way, kills over 70% of the animals it brings in.
So, what is it down there? It's a PETA, it's a shelter? Is it an office/shelter.
We sent some representatives down there to have a word.
Yeah, yeah.
And
dude,
what happened?
You dug that dirt up on them, too, that right when they're like, hey, stop killing these tasty crabs, you spin the camera back on them and say, oh, how about the tens of thousands of animals you've offed?
Yep. So, you know, I think they started responding to us at first, and then when we started digging out the facts from third-party sources, Huffington Post, you know, Fox, everywhere, they were like, okay, these guys know their stuff. Let's stop responding to them and just go away. So they stopped answering Jimmy's through social media.
Mm-hmm.
So now they just went to the back channels of trying to be cute and throw up another billboard and just keep digging into
that. So they have a second billboard coming up, right? So they have one that's on its way, and then you have a response.
Yeah, what's going to happen next?
Loaded and ready to go?
Look, guys, you know, we got the entire state of Maryland behind us.
Hell yeah.
We're not backing down anytime soon. So if they want to keep throwing up billboards, we'll do it as well until they pack their bags and get out of our state.
Hell yeah. Mike Anderson.
Well, I'm wondering, John, have you thought about having even more fun with this and maybe making a special vegan crab cake? In honor of PETA?
No.
And that's that.
Crab cakes, steaks, chicken,
I saw the
ribs.
Uh-huh. Yeah, it's getting to the point where you got your lovely lady there, by the way.
Oh,
shout out
God.
To your lady.
Smoke.
The pictures from Greece were amazing. Both of you, just Adonis.
I got mad at the pictures.
But you're sitting there cutting into a steak. What you eating for dinner there, John?
Nice savory ribeye. Look at I can hear it move.
As rare steak. As I can get it. The thing walked over by my table on its own.
Oh. Well, did you see the post that went viral with the Greek salad?
No.
We said, we have vegan options as well. I think Mike's got it pulled up over there.
Is that it right there?
That's
somebody,
Greek salad.
Somebody totally missed the joke.
Hell yeah. Like,
that's not vegan.
Yeah, we know. It's covered in delicious cheese and ham. And
then the response from Jimmy's was, we really don't care.
Yeah, we don't care. Dude, the apology video that you did after it started getting very, very heavy when you were like, listen, for a while now, we have been saying some things online. And we have tweeted some things that are controversial. And we would just like to say that anybody over the past few weeks that has been offended by what we have said, we apologize for absolutely nothing. And people went nuts for that, too.
Now, you know, the apology went over great.
Yeah.
I mean, internationally, but it was a little disappointing. Not many people picked up on the fact that we copied that word for word from Conor McGregor.
Conor McGregor. Yeah.
Like, hello. Like, it's obviously paying homage to the king.
Yeah, yeah.
Show a little love. Have the guy, you know, maybe tweet at Jimmy's a little bit.
Well, dude, it's been an absolute.
Yeah, we'll see how this story continues to unfold.
Exactly,
well, I can
man.
Tell you how it ends.
Oh.
Oh, please. Please.
Maryland 1, PETA 0.
All right.
Now, I'm going to just. Actually,
my pants are getting tight over here.
Yeah, he makes my belt buckle area tight. All right, Jimmy's Famous Seafood, Hollabird Avenue. The guy feeds the WWE. The guy does all kinds of great work. I think we're going to be doing something for Toys for Tots coming up in November, I believe.
December 21st.
December 21st. Very, very cool. John, thank you so much, buddy.
Thanks, guys.